So this is where we end up with the baby blue, and a lot of people and a lot of stories you hear talk about Grateful Dave and Billy and Big Lou, and there is only controversy when the corporate office tells us that there should be. The baby blue may not be what you have been told it is. The NAS Corporation has put out memos telling us that there needs to be controversy. The body of the baby blue is quite literally our original basic text.
And that was printed by the Recovery First Group in Narcotics Anonymous in Allentown, Pennsylvania. I call up Anthony and ask him when they want to get this thing over with, when they're going to sue us. And group conscience. When conscience is violated, it doesn't mean we go away. I was assaulted a few times, physical violence. I got attacked at a meeting. And tell him they should put his car in the ocean. You know, that's how they treated Big Lou. And they put his brand new car in the ocean in Biscayne Bay. Big Lou OD'd in the San Diego airport. You know, he went back out. He couldn't handle the pressure.
Do you know how Greg P. felt about the baby blue, that particular book?
Well, let's just say you had a couple cases of the baby blues.
If you were not paying $12 for a basic text, how much more would you put in that basket? Got the intro guide. So what we're gonna give people at low cost a little piece of the program. Is that what we're doing? Does it sound familiar? Does it sound like something from the street? You know, first taste is free, folks, and then after that you gotta pay for the good stuff. There's no other word. This is total addict bullshit. Can home groups not make motions? Areas can't make motions, and regions can't make motions. Some of them learn, wow, these traditions used to talk about the service structure is not part of the fellowship and can't tell us what to do. I like that idea. That's in the baby blue. Wonder why they took that out. Well, it's pretty obvious why they took that out. I can see the way World Services operates today. And they currently act as trustor and trustee, since all motions must be made by the World Board. And the World Board is responsible to and trained by the corporation. If you don't believe that, go ahead and look in your NAS financial reports. When a World Board member is elected after years of grooming, and I use the term elected very loosely, they are then trained by the corporation. Now, if they were listening to the fellowship, there wouldn't be tens of thousands of baby blues going out on a monthly basis. They seem to be using that term illicit quite loosely. The members who make up this fellowship own that literature. Let's talk about a man named Bo West. He testified that the fellowship and the addicts who make up the fellowship, the home groups, own that literature, and he thought World Services was wrong. This beautiful program has been hijacked and is being taken from you. The man who wrote our service structure said that the service structure is not a part of Narcotics Anonymous. People who created this literature and played the most prominent roles in creating the literature seem to feel like it's the fellowship's literature and that the World Board is wrong. Why can't we have free literature or a low-cost basic text? This is fundamentally an issue of economics. I'm going to read it again. This is fundamentally an issue of economics. $250,000 a year to train our World Board members and hold meetings. I mean, that's got to be some pretty expensive lunches and some pretty decent hotels. So really, when you don't buy a basic text at $12, are you really not funding the translation? Are you really not funding the message being carried? Are you not funding perks to World Board members? $500,000 every year, just so far, from those two little line items in World Board expenses, for all their talk of needing this $81 million to translate the basic text so that everybody can have it. It's been out for so many years. With that kind of money, how come it's not in every language already? If that's really what it's about, why over 10 years have we only spent $386,382? A 10-year total that is smaller than the amount we spend flying the World Board all over the world. Is it more important to have a basic text in every language, or to have a well-traveled World Board, a corporate-trained World Board? This is not an issue of economics. This is an issue of addicts dying behind fucking dollar signs.
And it's like, let's feed the children, but give 10% to the children and 90% to the administrators. Basically, because people feel that they've gone on unheard for such a protracted period of time that it's a useless endeavor. And I look at this kind of like, you know, okay, Dave, well, this is our response, and before we even talk, we're going to, you know, put you in fucking jail. Or we have a history in this country of nonviolent civil disobedience, and you know, that's how those who are participating in this in this situation view what it is that, you know, that we're doing. And I mean, it's not just two, it's not just three, but I mean, you know, we've in 3 weeks we moved 6,000 books, and they're from Maine to the Bahamas. I understand what involuntary dissolution means in terms of the California code, and I understand a whole bunch of things, you know?
You know, if we lock ourselves into the way it's done here, then we're not going to grow and develop and change.
I left the World Service Conference and I told them straight up, I'm going back to group service. We would never get a statement like, can't save your ass and your face at the same time, out of a professional writer. That had to come from a 17-year-old girl with 90 days sitting in the back of the room, who I must say is still clean today.
You know what I mean? So even if, hey, you know, it's just like the gray book. You know what I mean? There's a lot of addicts that never get to see the gray book. You know what I mean? But it's still out there. You know, thank God, because of some of the addicts that participate in As Is and Anonymous and organizations like that.
Other people are writing our literature right now, and I know that the therapeutic value of one addict helping another is without parallel, and it's another addict helping me is what's going to help me, not some therapist or some professional writer. So,
a branch of my home group, the Historical Perspective Group, they're writing the Five Tools pamphlet, and they're asking me, with 2 days clean, what do you think? What's your input, you know?
Well, you know what I've been looking for, and that's, you know, full disclosure and, you know, the direct responsibility and accountability. And, you know, it's unfortunate that these issues seem to be colliding all at the same time, but maybe God has something to do with that.